بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على النبي الكريم محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. As we mentioned before, that Sayyidina Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه, he constituted a committee of four people to preserve Quran and to compile it officially. And that committee was constituted of, our commission was constituted of four people: Abdullah ibn Zubair, Sa'id ibn al-As, Abdul Rahman ibn Harith ibn Hisham, and Zaid ibn Thabit. And as we mentioned before, that Zaid ibn Thabit radiallahu ta'ala an, he was the chief inscriber in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was given the responsibility in the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, to collect and gather together the Holy Quran. Now Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, he gave them one instruction, or made one wasiya in this regard, that in dialect, or in accent, you will differ each other, but whenever you have any difference in this regard, or any type of differences in this regard, فَكْتُبُوهُ بِلِغَةِ قُرَيْشٍ, so write that word in the dialect of Quraysh. فَإِنَّ الْقُرَانَ نَزَلَ بِلُغَتِهِمْ أَوَّلًا. For the first time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received this holy book in the lugha and dialect of Quraysh. And then they asked Sayyida Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anha, who had the first ever copy of Holy Quran compiled in the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, so she sent that copy to this commission or committee, and they started their work. So they compiled 7 copies of Holy Quran. At that time, the Islamic State, it had 7 big capitals. Number 1, Medina, the central capital. Number 2, Makkah. Number 3, Basra. Number 4, Kufa. Number 5, Bahrain. Number 6, Yemen. And number 7, Oman. And what happened to the copies of Quran? People did have before. So it is said that it was burnt with by the order of Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, and the ashes were buried somewhere. So that's why some ulama, they are of the view to burn the old pages of Holy Quran. That is allowed, while some others say that is makruh and dislike. The very pages should be buried somewhere. Got it? So that was the case of the preservation of Holy Quran. As far as the case of the preservation of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, as we mentioned before, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has taken the responsibility to preserve both types of wahi. Wahi Jali, which is the book of Allah, and Wahi Khafi, which is the hadith and sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we refer to ayah, inna nahnu nazzalna dhikr wa inna lahu lahafizun. That was chapter 15, ayah number 9. So how? It was preserved. So in this regard, some people, they are making a viral propaganda, which is a wrong one. The ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were not preserved in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and their propaganda that's based upon malafide intention. Yes. And that propaganda started with by the Westerners to confuse Muslims regarding ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what's the case of the writing of ahadith? So you should write two things. Number one, the very writing of ahadith. And number two, official compilation of ahadith. Official compilation means at-tadleen, ar-rasmi. At-tadleen, ar-rasmi means the compilation under the supervision of authority, means the khalifas or the rulers. So that is official compilation or at-tadleen, ar-rasmi. As far as the case of the writing of ahadith is concerned, so in this regard, there is only one hadith, and that is authentic. You should write it. Which is narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiyallahu ta'ala an. That Rasul Khudri, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تكتبوا عني ومن كتب عني غير القرآن فليمحو. وزاد في رواية حدث وفو عني ولا حرج ومن كذب علي فليتبوى مقده من النار أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. رابع صلى الله عليه وسلم said that لا تكتبوا عني, don't write from me. And whosoever wrote something except Quran, so he may erase it. And in another narration, it is said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Haddithu anni, relate from me, wala haraj, that is not a sin, or not such a thing which you would be blamed for. وَمَنْ كَتَبَ عَلَيَّ فَلْيَتَبَوَّ مَقَدَوْ مِنَ النَّارِ. But whosoever, he will attribute something false to me, so he is making his place in the hellfire. You should write it. They حَدِّثُ عَنِّي, relate from me. That is not a sin or a thing you would be blamed for. And whosoever attributed something falsely to me, he is making his place in the hellfire. Got it? There is another hadith narrated by Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه that the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala خرج علينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came out of his house towards us. وكنا نكتب الحديث, and we were writing a hadith. Right? And we were writing a hadith. So he asked us, what are you writing? We said, hadith. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a book, other than the book of Allah you mean? Look at my tone. A book, other than the book of Allah you mean? And he said furthermore, their people before you. They were not gone astray. But only with those books which they wrote with the book of Allah. When they wrote with the book of Allah. So in brackets you should write, which they wrote, yes, quote unquote, mixed with the book of Allah. People before you were not gone astray, but with the books they wrote mixed with the book of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Abu Huraira says, then I asked the messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, should we relate from you? Should we narrate from you? Write it down, every single word, so you may not be confused. Should we relate from you? Then you will correct the note from each other. He said, yes, narrate from me. That is not a sin. But whosoever will attribute to me something falsely, he is making his place in fire. Now this hadith of Abu Huraira is narrated by Imam Ahmad. But its narration chain is a weak one. You should write it. Remarks. The narration chain of this hadith, narrated by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, that's a weak one. Number three, Abu Sa'id says, I asked the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we can write a hadith. I asked the messenger of Allah if we can write a hadith. But he did not allow me. Hadith is narrated by Imam Tirmidhi. This hadith is narrated by Imam Tirmidhi. But again, its narration chain is weak as well. Number four. Zayd ibn Thabit said that the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited his hadith to be written. Again, the narration chain of this hadith is weak as well. Now, there is only one authentic hadith, and that is the first one related by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiyallahu ta'ala an. Now, what was the case of Sahaba regarding this prohibition of writing? So in this prohibition, there are the fatwas of various Sahaba, like Abu Sa'id, should write the name, Abu Huraira, Ibn Abbas, and Ibn Umar. But if all of them later on they wrote a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, later on all of them they wrote a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam themselves, so it means Their fatwa was not to depend and rely upon writing and to give up memorization. They were giving zero points to what? To memorization. So do not depend and rely upon writing. But try to memorize. Then most of them, like Abu Sa'id, Ibn Mas'ud, Abu Huraira, they wrote a hadith themselves. So as you mentioned, that this prohibition was, number one, not to write it mixed with the book of Allah. Not to write it mixed with the book of Allah. Or not to rely upon writing and not memorizing. Or this prohibition is abrogated. It was in the beginning. Later on it was abrogated. Because whenever a Sahabi relates something from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he himself practiced otherwise, so for sure that narration is abrogated. Got it? Regarding permission of writing, should write it. Regarding permission of writing, there are a lot of hadith, or there are so many hadith the number of these hadith approached the level of mutawatir. It approached the level of mutawatir. Mutawatir is something which is either related by uncountable numbers or practiced by uncountable numbers of people. These are hadith regarding permission. Number one, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he delivered his last sermon, khutbah, sermon means khutbah, his farewell sermon, S-R-T, S. In his Hajj, so there was someone from Yemen, his name was Abu Shah, his name was Abu Shah, he asked the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if somebody can write this sermon, so Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam added, Uktubu li Abi Shah. What he said? Uktubu li Abi Shah. Write it down for Abu Shah. So now, if the words of Rasulullah are his precious, was prohibited to be written, he would never have asked Sahaba to write it down for Abu Shah. Got it? So write it. In bracket. If writing up hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was prohibited, he would never have asked Sahaba to write it down for Abu Shah. Hadith number 2. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhu. Amr ibn al-As, the very conqueror of Egypt and the governor of Egypt, Dahiyatul Arab, one of the five famous Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In which he is in politics. Abdullah is his son. He was a young man, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He said that I was a good inscriber. Satnavis. What do you call Mahmoud? Khushnavis. Garhami Khahi ke Bashi Khushnavis. Me Navis. Yes? Sahin. Garhami Bashi Khahi ke Bashi Khushnavis. So what do you have to do? Me Navis. So he was a Navis under. Yes. He was a very good writer and a very good inscriber. So Abdullah says, radiyallahu ta'ala an, I used to write every single word of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the people of Quraysh said, don't write everything. They said, don't write everything. Sometimes the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in passion. P-A-S-S-I-O-N. And sometimes he is in tranquil. So Abdullah says, I came to the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I told him my situation with the people of Quraysh. Did I do right? Every single word of yours. But the people of Quraysh, they said, don't write every single word. Maybe he is in passion or in tranquil. Maybe he is angry or he is relaxed. You know what I'm saying? So when somebody is relaxed, he says something good, but he is angry, speaking otherwise. You know what I'm saying? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fa'ashara ila lisani yaw fa'akaza bi lisani. Look at me. He indicated towards his son. فَأَخَذَ بِلِسَانِهِ He held his son and he said, اُكْتُبْ كُلَّ مَا يَقُولُهُ فَوَاللَّهِ لَا يَتَكَلَّمُ إِلَّا بِحَقْ Let's write down every single word of this son. I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will never speak out any word but truth. Because this is not the tongue of the common layman. That's the tongue of the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is controlled with remote control from Allah's side. It's controlled by Allah. Write down everything coming out of this tongue. I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will never speak out a single word but only truth. So the words of Rasulullah's hadith, and he asked Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As to write it down. Number 3. Abu Huraira is referring to same Abdullah. Abu Huraira. He is referring to same Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. That nobody was more in ahadith than me, but only Abdullah. I heard a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a lot, or plenty. But only Abdullah, he had more than mine. And he mentioned the cause and reason. إِنَّهُ كَانَ يَكْتُبْ وَكُنْتُ لَا أُحْسِنُ الْكِتَابَ. Because he was putting everything on record, writing it down. And I was unable to write, I was memorizing. Abu Huraira said, Abdullah was writing and I was memorizing because I was unable to write it down. So you should write with notes. Later on, the same Abu Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he started writing down the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is a well-known scholar. He has written a book in Arabic language, and that is Jami'u Bayan al-Ilm li Ibn Abdul Barr. So this is the alim, Ibn Abdul Barr, and he has written this book, Jami'u Bayan al-Ilm. In that book, he related a story to write it. That one Sahabi, his name was Amr ibn Umayyah al-Dumari. Amr ibn Umayyah. Amr. Ibn Umayyah al-Dumari. Banu Dumar, that's his wife. He narrated a hadith from Abu Huraira. In front of Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira was sitting here. And Amr ibn Umayyah radiallahu ta'ala an, he narrated a hadith from Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an. Abu Huraira asked him, are you sure I have given you this hadith? You are related to me. You learnt it from me. Are you sure? Amr said, of course. So Abu Huraira took me to his library. And there was the library full of handwriting of Abu Huraira. That was the library which was full of the handwritings of Abu Huraira. So he was looking into these writings for that very hadith, and he found it and he approved it. Yes, I have given you this hadith. So it means Abu Huraira was writing as well. Have you got it? What's the bottom line? He was writing. You are becoming moldy. Yes. There is another riwayah. A Sahabi, he complained to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the weakness of his memory. That my memory is weak. I cannot memorize every single thing of you, O the Messenger of Allah. He complained to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the weakness of his memory. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, Istaghin ala hifzika. Biyaminika. Istaghin. Seek help for your record. Little meaning of these words. Seek help for your record of your right hand. means, now technical meaning will be like this, that seek help of your writing, your right hand for your memory or for your records. Means, write it down. Seek help of your right hand for your records. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave permission to that Sahabi to write his hadith. Another riwayah. Abdullah ibn Amr, the same one. And Anas ibn Malik, the personal servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abdullah ibn Amr and Anas ibn Malik. They both related a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Sayyidu. What? Sayyidu. Al-ilma. Bil-kitab. Sayyidu al-ilma. Bil-kitab. Written meaning is imprison knowledge with writing. Little meaning is imprison means reserve or preserve. Sayyidu, little meaning is imprison. So you cannot put Hayyid in prison. Yes? He is not a criminal. Yes. Criminal is there in Farah. So because he was in Farah, so that's why he became Farari. Yes, not Farari. So anyhow, Sayyidu, Al-ilm bil-kitab. Little meaning is that قيد يقيد تقييدا confined. قيد imprison, hold. So قيد العلم بالكتاب, preserve the knowledge with writing. This is right here. You wrote it? There is another hadith. Sahabi name is Rafi ibn Khadij radiyallahu ta'ala an. What his name? Rafi ibn Khadij. He says that we ask the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if he can write down the hadith. If he can write down the hadith. So he said, write it down. That's not a sin. Write it down. That's not a sin. Rizul Bastani. Al-Arab al-Mubassan. Al-Arab al-Mubassan. Yes, huh? He said, we can write Pakistani. In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the writing was taking place not with by the permission but by the order of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wrote letters after the pact of Hudaybiyah. And because of this treaty, he became relaxed from the side of the people of Makkah. Treaty was there, so he was feeling relaxed from their side. No any action will be taking place therefrom. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes, He transfers your attention towards other areas to convey them the message. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started writing letters to the kings.
To whom?
To the kings and rulers. And these were the words of Rasulullah. In other words, these were a hadith. These were words. So he himself not only wrote, but he asked to be written from. So he wrote a letter to Nagar.
To whom?
Nagar. His actual name was Athama.
What?
Athama ibn Abjar. The king of Abyssinia. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent his messenger with this letter. His name is Amr ibn Umayyah.
Who?
Amr ibn Umayyah. And then Nagar, the ruler, the king, he read the letter. He learned it. He got the message. Amr ibn Umayyah said, when I gave him the letter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-Malik,
yes, His Excellency,
what?
His Excellency, yes, Jinayat al-Malik,
what?
Jinayat al-Malik,
so in your area it's called Jinayat al-Malik in Afghanistan and Iran and Shahs were there,
Zahir Shah
and Raza Shah,
so they used to call him Al-Hazrat,
so he said Al-Hazrat,
yes,
His Excellency,
what?
Al-His Majesty,
yes, Subhanallah,
Majesty belongs to Allah only.
Jalala belongs to
Allah.
Why did he call others?
And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَبْغَضَ النَّاسِ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ الَّذِي يُسَمَّى مَلِكُ الْمُلُوكِ
Shahin Shah.
What?
Shahin Shah.
That the hated one in the sight of Allah is that one.
We'll call it himself Shahin Shah.
While Shahin Shah is only Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And that's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gets hold of such like Shahin Shah, he cannot find there's any reason to sit even.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be unfaithful.
Yes, be humble towards Allah. Every time. Never be proud. Never think of yourself very high. You are the slave of Allah. You are very weak. Allah is the only powerful entity. He is the only superior and sovereign. Nobody else is like. So anyhow. So Amr ibn Umayyah said, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that Athama ibn Abjar, he was sitting on his throne. He came down to the earth and sat on the earth, the king. He kissed the leper and put it on his eyes. And then he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. He converted to Muslim. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him that much respect. That when he got informed that Athama passed away, so Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed his salati janaza in Medina.
Yes.
What is respect? This was given to that king by whom? By Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number two. Another letter. It was written to Juraij ibn Matta.
Who?
Juraij ibn Matta, the king of Egypt. His title was Makukas.
What?
That's the title. That's the designation. Like president. His Magus was also the title of the king of Abyssinia. His name was Athama. The title was Magus. So his name was Juraij. The title was, yes, and this letter was taken by Hatib ibn Abi Baltah, radiallahu anhu. عاطب بن ابي بكر he took the letter to Makukas. Makukas read it to his translator or commentator, Sir Jaman. That was the way of protocol. The king is not going to read letter himself. That was the protocol. So that's why he asked for his Sir Jaman to read it. So he read it. Makukas, even though he did not accept Islam, this is right. But he respected the messenger of Allah, Hatib ibn Abi Bakr. He gave him a lot of respect. And he sent him back with lot of gifts. Amongst these gifts, there was one donkey for rice. That is a gift for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know what I'm saying? That's why Dhanji, because the king himself he was writing Dhanji. You know what I'm saying? So if the ruler from India, he will give you a gift of car, he will never give you a Mercedes. He will give you a car made in India. You know what I'm saying? Got it? Yes. So he sent him a Dhanji and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he named the Dhanji as Ofair. What? Ofair. And he sent to his presentation with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sent two of his nieces. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam want to marry any one of them and he want to give another one to some of his relative or his companion, one, her name was Siri. What? And the second one, her name was Maria. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he married Maria. And from that very lady, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he begot a son known by the name of Ibrahim, whose cover and grave is there in Jannatul Baqi in Madinah al-Munawwarah. He passed away when he was only 9 months. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at that time, he was 61 plus, means old man. So when he was going to perform his Sunati Janaza, so Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in old age, because two of his sons, they passed away in their childhood in Mecca, from Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. You know what I'm saying? From any other woman, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never begot any child. The only child he begot other than Khadija, that was from Maria. His name was Ibrahim. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf said, radiallahu ta'ala an, when we were going towards Jannatul Baqi to perform janaza, I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he broke in tears. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he broke in tears. So I looked at him, and before that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in one of his address, expecting who and crying the bit of your chit and chin, that's haram, that's not allowed, that's prohibited. So I said, wa anta ya Rasulullah, and you also, O the Messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told me, innu kalba yahzan, wal ayna sadma, wa inna bi firasika ya Ibrahim wa la mahzunun. Bihas, grief. Bihas, grief. Wal ayna sadma, and the eyes breaks in tears. And with by the death of Ibrahim, we are in grief. And then he told me, inna man hetu han haza wa haza. I prohibited you people not to slap your mouth on the death of your kit and kin, and not to say any word with your tongue. As far as the case of fear is concerned, that's not in the control of anybody. So anyhow, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he married this lady, Maria, and this other one was married to the official poet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His name was Hassan ibn Salih. His name was Hassan ibn Salih. So further more to Narab sahab, Harun, where is Harun? He's not here.